नंदिनी नंदित मेदिनी विश्व विनोदिनी नंदनुते गिरिवर विंध्य शिरो दिनी वासिनी विष्णु विलासिनी जिष्णुनुते भगवती हे शिति कंत कुतुम बिनी भूरि कुतुम बिनी कूरि कृते जय जय हे महिषासुर मर्दिनी रम्यक परदिनी शैलसुते दुर्वर वर्षिणि दुर्धर दर्शिनी दुर्मुख मर्षिणि हर्षरते त्रिभुवन पोषिणि शंकर तोषिणि किल विषमोषिणि गोशरते तनुजनि रोषिणि दिति सुत रोषिणि दुर्मद शोषिणि सिंधु सुते जय जय हे महिषा सुर मर्दिनि रम्यक पर्दिनि शैल सुते अहि जगदंब मदंब कदंब वन प्रियवासिनि हासरते शिखर शिरोमणि तुंग हिमालय शिखगनि चालय मदयगते मधु मधुरे मधु कैतब गंजिनि कैतब वंजिनि हासरते जय जय हे महिषा सुर मर्दिनि रम्यक पर्दिनि शैल सुते आहि शरणागत भैरव दूवर वीरवरा बहिदायक रे त्रिभुवन मस्तक शूल विरोधि शिरो विकृतामल शूलक रे दुमि दुमि तामर दुंदु विनाद महो मुकरी कृत दिंगमक रे जय जय हे महिषासुर मर्दिनि रम्यक पर्दिनि शैल सुते अनुरनु शंगर नाकशन संग परी स्पुर दंगन काटकट के कनक पिशंग प्रिशत कनि शंगर सत भत शिंग हतार बतुके रित चतुरंग बलक्षिति रंग गतत बहुरंग रतत बतुके जय जय हे महिषासुर मर्दिनि रम्यक पर्दिनि शैल सुते अहि सुमन 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 सुमनोहर कांति युते श्रित रजनी 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 कर वक्र वृते सुनयन विभ्रमर भ्रमर 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 भ्रमराधिपते जय जय हे महिषासुर मर्दिनि रम्यक पर्दिनि शैल सुते कर मुरली रव बीजित कूजित लजित कोकिल मंज मते मिलित पुलिंग मनो हर गुंजित रंजित शैल निकुंज जगते निज गुण भूत महा शबरी गण सद्गुण संवृत केलितले जय जय हे महिषासुर मर्दिनि रम्यक पर्दिनि शैल सुते विजित सहस्त्र करेक सहस्त्र करेक सहस्त्र करेक नुते वित सुर तारक संगर तारक संगर तारक सुनु सुते सुरत समाधि समान समाधि 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 सुजातर ते जय जय हे महिषासुर मर्दिनि रम्यक पर्दिनि शैल सुते तव भवविमलेदु कुलं वेदनेदु मलं सुकलं ननुकूलयते किमु पुरहूत पुरिंदु मुखी सुमुखी बिरसहु विमुखी क्रियते मम तु मतं शिवन मदने भवती कृपया किमुता क्रियते जय जय हे महिषासुर मर्दिनी रम्यक परदिनी शैलसुते महि महि दीन दयालु तया कृपयैव तया भवितव यमुहे अहि जगतो जननी कृपया सियता सितता नुमुता सिरते यदुचित मात्र भवत युररी कुरुता दुरुता पम पाकुत्रते जय जय हे महिषा सुरमर्दिनी रम्यक परदिनि शैलसुते जय जय हे महिषासुरमर्दिनी रम्यक परदिनी 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 शैलसुते ओम श्री राम कृष्ण भगवान की जय पावन सुत हनुमान की जय श्री अम्बे अम्बे मात की जय श्री महाकाली महालक्ष्मी महासरस्वती महादुर्गा माता की जय
देवी प्रपन्नार्ति हरे प्रसीद प्रसीद मातर जगत खिलस्स प्रसीद विश्वेश्वरी पाहि विश्वम त्वमीश्वरी देवी चराचरस्य यथाग्नेर दाहिका शक्ति रामकृष्णे स्थिता हिया सर्वविद्या स्वरूपां तां शारदां प्रणमाम्यहम् ओ देवी यू हू रिमूव द सफरिंग्स ऑफ योर सप्लायंट्स बी ग्रेसियस बी प्रोपिशियस ओ मदर ऑफ द होल वर्ल्ड Be gracious, O Mother of the universe, protect the universe. You are, O Devi, the ruler of all that is moving and unmoving. Pranams to Holy Mother Sharada Devi, Sri Ramakrishna and Swami Vivekananda. Pranams to Ma Durga. Om Namo Narayanaya, dear devotees. I am very glad to announce that during this Navaratri days, today's subject is Durga Puja in Belur Math, and it will be described, this spoken today, this discourse will be given by revered Swami Dibyananda Ji Maharaj, who is presently a trustee of the Ramakrishna Math and Mission, and also he is the head of our Sharada Pit Center. Sharada Pit is just outside Belur Math, that center, and I am glad to work under Swamiji. When I was headmaster in Malda, Swami Dibyananda Maharaj was head there. He was a long time principal in our Rahora College. He was vice principal in our Vidya Mandir College, and he was head of Malda Center. Now he is head of our Sharada Pit Center. I am grateful and thankful to revered Maharaj, and I convey pranams from myself and all the devotees of South Africa for accepting our request and giving consent to give a discourse on this wonderful subject, because he has been a pujari for a long period. He was pujari in Belur Math and he was Tantra Dharak in many other centers. So this Durga Puja in Belur Math is a very wonderful subject, very near to his heart. And I hope, as on other days, devotees are very happy to have the discourses given by the different Swamis, scholarly Swamis of our different centers. Today we have got revered Swami Dibyanandaji Maharaj amongst us, and I request revered Maharaj to deliver his discourse on the topic Sri Sri Durga Puja in Belur Math. And once again I offer my pranams on behalf of this center and the devotees of South Africa, and may we all pray to the Divine Mother to bless us all with bliss, peace, joy, prosperity and spiritual upliftment, and keep us in good health during this pandemic crisis, and destroy all our evils. As Mother is the protector, may the Divine Mother be gracious to us, and may she protect us from all dangers. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti.
The monastic order of Sri Ramakrishna, unlike the earlier monastic traditions, is unique in many ways. One such uniqueness is its effortless ability to adapt itself with the modern scientific values. Yet another equally unique characteristic is its feeling at home with the ritualistic traditions of all religions. And sure enough, it was Swami Vivekananda himself who started the first Durga Puja at Belur Math in 1901. One might ask, why did Swamiji start the new tradition when it is not quite the norm for the Hindu sannyasins to participate in ritualistic worship? One reason was to remove the misgivings of Hindu society in Calcutta about the new monastic institution at Belur Math. As many of these people looked askance at unconventional ways of life at Belur Math, which included disregard for caste rules and mixing with Western people. The other reason was rather esoteric. A few days before Durga Puja in 1901, Swamiji had a vision of Durga Puja being done at Belur Math. More or less at that time, Swami Brahmanandaji saw in a vision Mother Durga coming across the Ganga from Dakshineshwar to Belur Math. Swamiji asked Raja Maharaj Brahmanandaji to make preparations for Durga Puja immediately, although only a few days were left to begin the puja. Inquiries at Kumatuli revealed that there was a single beautiful image of Durga in a shop. Apart from the image, a lot of other things had to be collected for the elaborate ritualistic worship. Under able direction of Swami Brahmanandaji, everything was done well at short notice. The invocatory worship on Shashti was on 18 October 1901. The pujari was Brahmachari Krishna Lal, and the Tantradharak was Ishwar Chandra Chakravarti, the father of Sasi Maharaj. Sitting under the bell tree, Swamiji sang Agamani songs, welcoming the Divine Mother. Also on Ashtami day, Swamiji himself worshipped 9 little girls as Kumaris. He placed flowers at the feet of the Kumaris and offered sweets and Dakshina in their hands. He then prostrated before them. When Swamiji decided to celebrate Durga Puja at Belur Math, one of the first things he did was to seek the approval of Holy Mother Sharada Devi, who was then staying at Bagh Bazar in Kolkata. Mother wholeheartedly approved the proposal. Since sannyasins cannot undertake this kind of ritualistic worship, Swamiji decreed that the puja should be done in the name of Holy Mother Sharada Devi. This became a tradition which continues to this day. On Shashti day, Holy Mother came with other women devotees and stayed at Nidambar Babu's garden house nearby. Mother attended the awakening ceremony, Bodhana, that day and attended the puja on all the three subsequent days. Holy Mother attended the Durga Puja at Belur Math in 1912 and in 1916 and perhaps in some other years also. Each time Mother stayed for a few days and blessed her monastic and lay children. Let me now move on to a few personal memories of being the pujari along with revered Dhyanatmanandaji Maharaj, disciple of Sivanandaji Mahapurush Maharaj, as the Tantradharaka in the Durga Puja at Belur Math. Once before the start of Bodhana Puja, I, accompanied by revered Dhyanatmanandaji Maharaj, went to offer pranams to most revered Swami Nirmanandaji Maharaj. When we informed most revered Nirmanandaji Maharaj that we would be worshipping Divine Mother, revered Maharaj, to my great amazement, told us that he had seen the Divine Mother cross the Ganges and enter the Belur Math courtyard with all her family members. Revered Maharaj then asked us to dwell on the living presence of the Divine Mother at Belur Math. Most revered Maharaj himself used to come to the Puja Mandapam in the morning to witness the Mahasnana, the great bath of the Divine Mother on the Mahashtami day. Indeed, in the presence of the senior monks, at that time most of them happened to be the disciples of the direct disciples of Sri Ramakrishna, a profound spiritual atmosphere would be created in the Puja Mandapam, and one would feel as if Divine Mother was verily present there. Traditionally, Durga Puja at Belur Math has always been a spiritually elevating experience for many of the devotees. Revered Dhyanatmanandaji Maharaj deeply impressed upon me that Mother Durga in the image was a living presence, and he would exhort us to feel the same. He had the unshakable faith in the divine presence of the Holy Mother during the puja, as promised by her that she would come every year to witness and accept puja. He used to tell Delhi during Durga Puja days that think that Mother has come and is witnessing your puja. He also knew for a fact that Holy Mother, as pointed out by none other than Swamiji, was herself the living Durga, Janta Durga. I am also reminded of a wonderful experience brought about by my Tantradharak Dhyanatmanandaji's holy association. This incident took place on a Vijaya Dashami day at Belur Math. I was performing Panchopachara puja with five articles of Lord Shiva, with revered Maharaj by my side as the Tantradharaka. Just as I was offering sandal paste to Lord Shiva, suddenly between revered Maharaj and myself, a very poor looking boy appeared, carrying in an arum leaf some flowers, billa leaves, dhutura flowers, etc., all the items being conducive to the worship of Lord Shiva. I was hesitant to keep these on the flower plate, as the purification of flowers of Pushpa Shuddhi has already taken place. To my surprise, revered Maharaj, my Tantradharaka, instructed me to keep these flowers on the flower plate and worship Lord Shiva with these newly brought flowers and billa leaves. The boy went out of the Puja Mandapam as suddenly as he appeared. Indeed, when revered Maharaj said in a slightly loud voice that Lord Shiva himself came with flowers and bell leaves for his own puja, a thrill passed through my body. For a few minutes, I felt silent and felt strangely restful. Till now, that memory fills me with peace. In conclusion, let us remember, Swamiji looked upon Sri Sarada Devi as the divine counterpart of Sri Ramakrishna, born for the awakening of womankind in the modern world, and by decreeing that the Durga Puja in the Belur Math should be done in the name of Holy Mother. Swamiji verily institutionalized respect for divinity of motherhood and sanctity of womanhood. Let us hope and pray that the worship of Divine Mother, as initiated by Swamiji, will continue to elevate human civilization to greater and yet greater glory. With this idea, till this day, Mother Durga is worshipped in image or in photographs or in ghatam, and all our devotees in India and abroad think of living presence of Goddess Durga during these days and enjoy a divine life during these 5 days. Let me conclude by repeating 2 mantras which we do during each day of worship of Goddess Durga. First is Devi's Dhyana Mantra, mantra for meditation. Om Rim Jata Juta Sama Yukta Mardendu Krita Shekharam Lochanatra Sangyuktaam Purnindu Shadrishananam Atasi Puspabarnabham Supratishtam Sulochanam Navajovana Sampannam Sarvabharanabhushitam Sucharu Dasanam Tadavat Pinonatapayodharam Tibhangasthana Sangsthanam Mahishasuramardinim Minalayata Sansparsha Dasabahu Samannitam Tishulam Dakshine Deyam Khadagam Chakram Kramadadha Tishnabanam Tathasaktim Dakshine Subichintaye Khetakam Purna Chapancha Pasamam Kusamevacha Gantang Baparshung Bapi Bamatas Sannibeshaye Adhastan Mahisan Tadabad Bishiraskam Pradarshaye Siras Chedod Bhavam Tadabad Danavam Khadagapaninam Idi Sulena Nirvinyang Nibjadantra Bihushitam Raktaraktikitam Gancha Rakta Vishpuri Tekshanam Beshtitam Nagapasena Bhrukutir Vishanananam Sapasapam Hastena Ditake Sancha Durgaya Bamadrudhira Vaktrancha Devya Singham Pradarshaye Devya Astu Dakshinam Padam Samam Shingo Paristitam Kinchidurdham Tatha Bamamangustam Mahishopari Stuyamanancha Tadrupam Amarai Sannibeshaye Ugrachanda Pachanda Chachandugra Chandanayika Chanda Chandavati Chaiva Chandarupati Chandika Abhi Shakti Virastabhi Satatam Paribeshtitam Chintayeti Jagatam Dhatrim Dharma Kamartha Mokshadam. After Dhyana Mantra, we worship Mother Durga with mental articles, Manasupajara. This is called Manasa Puja. Om Hit Padmam Asanam Dajjat Sahasrara Chutam Ritai Pajjam Charanayor Dajjat Manastvarikam Nivedai Tenam Ritenachmaniyam Snaniyam Tenacha Smritam Akashatattam Vastram Shat Gandhashat Gandhatattvakam Chittam Prakalpayet Pushpam Dhupam Pranam Prakalpayet Tejas Tattvancha Deepartham Naivedyam Shat Sudham Budhi Anahat Dhanir Ghanta Vayutattvancha Chamaram Sahasraram Bhavichatram Shardatattvancha Gitakam Nityam Indriya Karmani Chanchalyam Manasastatha Sumekhalam Padmamalam Pushpam Nana Vidam Tatha Amayat Dair Bhava Pushpair Archayet Bhava Gocharam Amayam Anahamkaram Aragam Amadam Tatha Amohakam Adambancha Addesha Akshobhakau Tatha Amatsajjamalobhancha Dasapushpam Vidurbudha Ahimsaparamam Pushpam Pushpam Indriya Vinigraha Dayapushpam Samapushpam Jnanapushpancha Panchamam Iti Panchadasai Bhavapushpai Sampujayet Sivam. At the end of the puja, we repeat daily Sri Sri Durga's Tavaraja. This is like this. Om Namaste Saranye Shiveshanukampe Namaste Jagat Vyapike Vishwarupe Namaste Jagat Bandhapadarvinde Namaste Jagat Tarini Trahi Durge. नमस्ते जगच्चिन्तमानस स्वरूपे, नमस्ते महायोगिनी ज्ञान रूपे, नमस्ते सदानंद नंद स्वरूपे, नमस्ते जगत्तारिणी त्राहि दुर्गे, अनाथस्य दीनस्य तृष्णातुरस्य क्षुधार्तस्य भीतस्य बद्धस्य जन्तो त्वमेकागतिर्देवि निस्तारकर्त्री, नमस्ते जगत्तारिणी त्राहि दुर्गे, अरण्ये रणे दारुणे शत्रुमध्ये अनले सागरे प्रांतरे राजगेहे त्वमेकागतिर्देवि निस्तार हेतुर, नमस्ते जगत्तारिणी त्राहि दुर्गे, अपारे महादुस्तरे अत्यंत घोरे विपद सागरे मज्जताम देहभाजाम त्वमेकागतिर्देवि निस्तार नौका, नमस्ते जगत्तारिणी त्राहि दुर्गे, नमश्चण्डिके चंद दुर्दंड लीला समुत्खंडिता खंडला शेष भीते त्वमेकागतिर्विघ्न संदोहंत्री, नमस्ते जगत्तारिणी त्राहि दुर्गे, त्वमेकाजिताराधिता सत्यवादिन्नमेयाजिता क्रोधना क्रोधनिष्ठा इरा पिंगला त्वं सुषुम्ना च नाडी, नमस्ते जगत्तारिणी त्राहि दुर्गे, नमो देवी दुर्गे शिवे भीमनादे सरस्वत्यरुन्धत्यमोघस्वरूपे विभूति शची कालरात्रि सती त्वं, नमस्ते जगत्तारिणी त्राहि दुर्गे, शरणमशिशुराणां सिद्ध विद्याधराणां मुनीतनुजनरानां व्याधिविपीडितानां निपतिगृहगतानां दस्तुवीरावृतानां तमसि शरणमेका देवी दुर्गे प्रसीद। ईदं स्तोत्रं मया प्रोक्तमापदुद्धारहेतुकं त्रिषण्डमेकषण्डं वा पठनादेव सङ्कटात् मुच्यते नात्र सन्देहो भुवि सर्गिरसातले, समस्तश्लोकमेकं वा यः पठेद् भक्तितः सदा स सर्वदुष्कृतिं त्यक्त्वा प्राप्नोति परमां गतिं, पठनादस्य देवेशि किं न सिद्ध्यति भूतले, स्तवराज इति देवी तव स्नेहात् प्रकाशित। On the Bodhana day, we repeat Brahma Krita Devi Stuti. Tvam Swaha, Tvam Sadha, Tvam Hi Bhashatkar Sharatmika, Sudha Tamakshare Nitte, Tridha Matratmika Sthita, Ardha Matra Sthita Nitya, Yanu Charja Visheshata, Tvameva Shastvam Savitri, तं देव जननी परा, तैव धार्यते सर्वं, तैः तत्सृज्यते जगत्, तैः तत्पाल्यते देवी, त्वमत्सन्ते च सर्वदा, विशिष्टौ सृष्टिरूपा, त्वं स्थितिरूपा च पालने, तथा संहृतिरूपान्ते, जगद्वश्य जगन्मये, महाविद्या, महामाया, महामेधा, महास्मृतिः, महामोहा च भवति, महादेवी, महासुरी, प्रकृतिस्त्वं हि सर्वस्य गुणत्रयविभाविनी, कालरात्रि महारात्रि मोहरात्रिश्च दारुणा, त्वं स्त्री त्वमीश्वरी त्वं हि त्वं बुद्धिर्बोधलक्षणा, लज्जा पुष्टि तथा तुष्टि त्वं शान्ति क्षान्तिरेव च, खड्गिनी शूलिनी घोरा गदिनी चक्रिणी तथा शङ्किनी चापिनी बाण भूषण्डी परिघायुधा, सौम्या सौम्यतरा शेष सम्यग्स्तति सुन्दरी, परा परानां परमा त्वमेव परमेश्वरी, यच्च किञ्चित् कचिद् वस्तु शतशतबाखिलात्मिके तस्य सर्वस्य या शक्ति सा त्वं, किं स्तूयसे मया, यया त्वया जगत्सृष्ट्वा जगत्पातात्तिजो जगत्, सोऽपि निद्रावशं नीत कस्त्वां स्तुतुमिहेश्वर, विष्णु शरीरग्रहणम् अहमीशानेव च, कारितास्ते जतो अतस्त्वां कस्ततुं शक्तिमान् भवेत्, सा त्वमित्थं प्रभावै शैरुदारै देवी संस्तुता, मोहयितौ दुराधर्षापशुरौ मधुकैटभौ, प्रबोधञ्च जगत्स्वामी नियतामच्युतो लघु, बोधस्य क्रियतामस्य अन्तुमेतौ महाशुरौ। इन् दिस् वे दे आर् अ वेरि ब्यूटिफुल् मन्त्रस् which we repeat daily during Durga Puja from Panchami to Dasami, and we do not utter the mantras only, we think of the meaning of these mantras and we try to see goddess Durga in everybody, especially in our mothers, in all women. Once in during Kumari Puja, after the worship of Koti Yogini, crores of yoginis, associates of Mother Durga, Tantradhara caste, the Pujari, do you like to see this Koti Yogini or crores of yoginis? Pujari responded positively and he pointed out to the witness group of mothers, about 10 to 15,000 mothers were looking at the living goddess worship, Kumari Puja. He told, these are the crores of yoginis. They are the associate of mother. Whenever mother comes, they come. And when they come, then mother's living presence is felt by us. Yes, this is the puja, special puja at Belur Math on the Durga Puja days. Nowhere we see such details of worship, uttering all the mantras and everything clean and quiet, and the volunteers, the monks, they work hard during the puja to make it a grand success. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Hari Om Tat Sat, Sri Ramakrishna Arpanamastu.
Today, I am very happy to announce that we have got another speaker on the topic, the significance of Durga Puja. Swami Tattvamayanandaji Maharaj, Sri Vyar Swami Tattvamayanandaji Maharaj, who is our head of our Los Angeles Center, America, will speak on this subject. The Swamiji is a scholarly monk. He was the Acharya teacher in our training centers for the probationers, Brahmacharis. And I am thankful and grateful to the Swamiji for accepting our invitation. The moment I have requested, the Swami is a very busy Swami, and he immediately accepted my request. And I hope the devotees, as on other days today also, will enjoy and feel enriched and enlightened and uplifted through this discourse by the scholarly Swamiji, who is the head of our Los Angeles Center, Swami Tattvamayanandaji Maharaj. So may we all pray to the Divine Mother to bless us all with good health, peace, bliss, and spiritual upliftment. And may she protect us from all dangers, and may she be gracious to all her, to us, her children. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti.
स्थापकाय च धर्मस्य सर्वधर्मस्वरूपिणे अवतारवरिष्ठाय रामकृष्णाय ते नमः. द हिंदू वेदिक एंड वेदांतिक ट्रेडिशन हैज गॉट सेवरल फॉर्म्स ऑफ द डिवाइन आइडियल्स, डिफरेंट डिवाइन कॉन्सेप्ट्स. इन द वेदिक लिटरेचर यू फाइंड डिफरेंट फॉर्म्स ऑफ pantheism, panentheism, polytheism, and monotheism, and so on. Of all these various concepts of gods and goddesses, the most sublime and the most exalted form of monotheism is worshipping the divine as the all-pervading divine feminine archetype. It's called Shakti Puja in Indian tradition. It has got various forms in different parts of India. That's because the mother ideal is the highest and the most sublime ideal in human relations. In fact, the relationship between the mother and the child is the most sacred, the most natural, and the most unbreakable form of human relationship. Now, if we can bring in this most intimate form of human relationship into spirituality that takes the form of worshipping the Divine Mother as the all-pervading spiritual energy. In the Vedic tradition, there is an interesting convocation address. Students who are departing from the Vedic hermitage after 12 years of education are given some instructions by teachers. Vedamanuchya acharya andayavasina manishasti satyam vada dharmam chara satyana pramudavyam dharmana pramudavyam mātrudevo bhava pitudevo bhava acharyadevo bhava adithidevo bhava. Is a convocation address, perhaps the first convocation address ever recorded in the history of human civilization. It comes in the Taittiriya Upanishad, in the Krishna Yajurveda. A teacher is addressing a group of students who are leaving the Vedic school, going to their homes to start their life as householders, playing different roles in the household, like husband, wife, sister, brother, and so on. So the most precious and the most important instruction given to these students is Matrudevo Bhava. That's the first instruction. It means you should respect and revere your mother as much as you honor God Himself. That is the implication. That means the mother is the most intimate and the most important figure in the household. Now, this intimate and natural human relation is transferred to spirituality. And Durga Puja is one of the most exalted forms of worship in Hindu Vedantic tradition. Because in the mother worship, the mother is considered to be Bhukti Mukti Pradayini, the one who gives you material prosperity and also spiritual wisdom and spiritual liberation. That's why one of the most important synonyms for the Divine Mother is Sharada. It is pronounced in two different ways with two different spellings in English. S-H-A-R-A-D-A is Sharada. The other name is Sarada. S-A-R-A-D-A. Sharada means Sharatkale Pujida Idi Sharada. The Divine Mother who is worshipped during the autumnal season. So, the autumn season is a symbol of prosperity, healthy climate, and peace and tranquility in society. Sharadi Avibhuda Sharada, that is also another derivation. What it means is, this mother descends to the earth during this autumnal season. Mahalaya corresponds to the time when the Divine Mother descends to the earth. It's a very important day as the beginning of this Durga Puja season. So the Divine Mother, who is the symbol, is the giver of material prosperity, happiness and joy, descends to the earth on this particular day and special during this special season, autumnal season. So she is called Sharada. The other important derivation is Saram Dadadi Idi Sarada. Saram means spiritual wisdom. So the mother not only gives you a material prosperity, but also gives you the spiritual wisdom to understand the limitation of material prosperity. So the mother is the one who gives us material prosperity and happiness and also spiritual wisdom. So that's why this Durga Puja is considered to be the most exalted form of monotheistic spiritual worship. About this Mahalaya, there are some very important aspects regarding this celebration. The new moon is called Amavasya because it is on that day that the sun and the moon come nearest to each other. Surya Chandramasoho Yap Para Sannikasa Sama Amavasya, that Govinda Tantra says. So the sun and moon coming together. According to some other tradition, this descent of the divine matter also is symbolic of the blending of jnanam and bhakti. Jnanam and bhakti. Bhakti, that is devotion, and spiritual knowledge and spiritual realization, both are involved in this concept. There are different forms of puja in Vedantic tradition. Sattvika, Rajasika and Tamasika. So sometimes when we give importance to devotion, chanting of mantra properly, austerity, fasting, meditation, it is called a puja form which emphasis on sattva-guna. When we give a lot of importance to external grandeur, pomposity, it is called Rajasika form of worship. And of course, when some people sometimes worship without giving much importance to any of these higher concepts, it is called Tamasika form of worship. Now, in the Durga Puja tradition, there are a few important things. What we are doing during puja, we are actually invoking the presence of the divine energy present everywhere. The divine energy which is all pervading, omnipresent and immanent everywhere is invoked, is requested to be present on that divine image. The image is made in such a way that it is a symbol of beauty, auspiciousness and sacredness. So with these values, when we do puja, the Divine Mother makes herself present on that image. Then when we do puja, we offer different things, argya, padya and naivedya, all these different items. Just as we honor a guest, an honorable guest is invited to our home, we give that guest an exalted place to sit, and then we humbly offer pranams, offerings with all respect, and finally we after giving everything, the mother blesses the devotee, and then the mother is requested to go back to her exalted home place. So this is the concept of mother worship. So mother worship is so very important in modern times, and that's because of the sacredness and sanctity of the relationship between the child and mother. Because a child can ask the mother for anything. He may not be able to ask his father for everything. The mother cannot deny her child's request. Mother will be always compassionate and considerate and caring for her children. The children find solace in the lap of the Divine Mother. Similarly, the Divine Mother Durga is the giver of not only spiritual wisdom but also material prosperity. Material prosperity alone cannot give us peace of mind. It can give us success. It can give us a lot of other wonderful things, good job, lot of money, wealth and so on. But that's not enough to make our life complete, and it's not enough for to get contentment. Without contentment, our life becomes poor. So we not only need material prosperity, but also we need the spiritual wisdom to understand that material prosperity cannot give us eternal peace and happiness and contentment. That's why in the Vedantic tradition, there is this Rajarshi concept. The ideal ruler is called a philosopher king. He is a king because he is efficient, he has plenty of material prosperity, success, wealth, everything, reputation and everything. But that's not enough. That will not give us contentment, satisfaction. The most successful person, the wealthiest person in the world, is sometimes most miserable. So he needs something else, that is spiritual wisdom. Rishittum. So Rajittum Aishwarya Sambhati Rishittum Tasyaka Sukshmartha Dasana Kshamattum. It is quoted by some commentators in the Shakta Tantra tradition. So the king represents material prosperity and success. The sage represents the contemplative nature, the spiritual wisdom that can teach us, that can make us understand the limits of material prosperity. So the mother can give us bhukti, success, everything. A child can ask her mother for anything. A child can feel free to ask her or his mother for anything that she wants. The mother will not deny anything. But mother will give the child everything that she needs, but eventually she also makes her undergo certain experiences which will make the child turn to mother and plead for spiritual wisdom. And then mother gives mukti also. That's why mother is called bhukti mukti pradayini. In this regard, we should remember there are some very important aspects with regard to the different days on which we perform this Durga Puja. Ashtami is an important date. Ashtami comes from the root as vyaptu, therefore the suggestive of the omnipresence of Devi. So those who perform puja on Ashtami will realize the omnipresent nature of the Divine Mother. And then so Durgashtami suggests the omnipresence of Durga. And again, of course, there are different rituals in the Vedic tradition. Similarly, there are certain rituals like belly, offering and so on. The very concept of belly itself is symbolic of giving up of ego. It may be performed as a special ritual, but the underlying message behind is giving up of our ego. In the Durga Suktam, the Rigvedya Devi Suktam is mentioned, Aham Rashtri Sangamani Vasunam Chigudushi Prathama Yakiyanam. The mantra says, Aham Rashtri, in this Durga Sukta, the Divine Mother is depicted as the omnipresent controller of the entire universe. And that Divine Mother is also present as the spiritual power in all of us, sitting within us, helping us, blessing us, and slowly regulating our life. The Mother makes our life happy. At the same time, the Mother also will teach us that material happiness is not enough to make our life complete. We are able to live a complete life when we blend material success with spiritual tradition, spiritual culture. In modern times, the very concept of Durga Puja, the very tradition of Durga Puja was given a sublime form by Sri Ramakrishna, who lived in India. He was born in 1836 and passed away in 1886. Sri Ramakrishna was the one who in modern times gave a new spiritual orientation to the very concept of Shakti worship. Of course, we find the same Shakti tradition was renewed by Shankaracharya in the 8th century. Shankaracharya, who is the original exponent of Advaita philosophy, also wrote 65 devotional poems, And some of these poems are actually dedicated to the Divine Mother. Saundarya Lahari, Ananda Lahari, Chadushashti Upajara Puja Stotram, it describes different upajaras of Mother worship. So, Shankaracharya renewed and gave a sublime orientation to the Shakti Puja tradition in 8th century. But in modern times, with the emergence of Sri Ramakrishna, Holy Mother and Swamiji, the very concept of Mother worship, the very concept of Durga Puja got a sublime new orientation, and Sri Ramakrishna himself was one of the greatest and most exalted exponent of Divine Mother worship in modern times. So also Swamiji and Sri Holy Mother. So I have tried to give you a very broad view of some aspects of Durga Puja. It is the most intimate form of relationship between the sadhaka and the sadhya, between the spiritual seeker and the Supreme Godhead. When the divine archetype, when God is worshipped in the form of all-compassionate, all-knowing Divine Mother, that worship becomes so natural, so intimate. Anyone can approach God as Mother, because as I mentioned earlier, Mother has no conventions. Mother doesn't follow any etiquettes. You can approach your Mother anytime, in any way you want. Mother is only person whom you can approach all the time without any reservation. So when we worship the Divine Mother as the Supreme Godhead, that becomes the most exalted form of monotheistic worship. And thank you. Namaskar. Om Shanti 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 Harihi Om Tat Sat Sri Ramakrishna Arpanamastu.
माँ तेरी ममता कितनी प्यारी, कितना प्यार जगाती है, कितना प्यार जगाती है। माँ तेरी ममता कितनी प्यारी, कितना प्यार जगाती है, कितना प्यार जगाती है। श्वास श्वास की रक्षा करती, पग पग प्राण बचाती है, कितना प्यार जगाती है। श्वास श्वास की रक्षा करती, पग पग प्राण बचाती है, कितना प्यार जगाती है। माँ तेरी ममता कितनी प्यारी, कितना प्यार जगाती है, कितना प्यार जगाती है। शंकर की शक्ति माँ तू ऋषियों की रीति सिद्धि तू ब्रह्मा की भक्ति माँ तू विष्णु की माया देवी तू शंकर की शक्ति माँ तू मातों से भाग जगाती भागी भागी आती है इतना प्यार जगाती है माँ तेरी ममता कितनी प्यारी कितना प्यार जगाती है कितना प्यार जगाती है महाकाली दुर्गा तू ही पाल भवानी माँ तू पूरन का तार शारदा तू वेदों की वाणी माँ तू काली महाकाली दुर्गा पाल भवानी माँ तू पूरन का तार शारदा तू वेदों की वाणी माँ तू बालक को गोद मिले कर जीवन गीत सुनाती है कितना प्यार जगाती है माँ तेरी ममता कितनी प्यारी कितना प्यार जगाती है कितना प्यार जगाती है श्वास श्वास की रक्षा करती पग पग प्राण बचाती है कितना प्यार जगाती है माँ तेरी ममता कितनी प्यारी कितना प्यार जगाती है कितना प्यार जगाती है कितना प्यार जगाती है कितना प्यार जगाती कितना प्यार जगाती है कितना प्यार जगाती है कितना प्यार जगाती है कितना प्यार जगाती है ओम श्री राम कृष्ण भगवान की जय पावन सुत हनुमान की जय श्री अम्बे अम्बे मात की जय श्री महाकाली महालक्ष्मी महासरस्वती महादुर्गा माता की जय
स्वस्तिर्भवतु सर्वेषां शान्तिर्भवतु। शांति शांति ओम हरि ओम तत्सत बोलो जय श्री गुरु।